Hello students, this is class 10th subject English and this is revision of chapter 4 from the diary of Annie Frank. This chapter is given in your book First Flight. We have already discussed chapter highlights, summary, new words, everything we have discussed about this chapter, but now we are going to revise it once again. So, this is a kind of recapitulation for you. From the diary of Annie Frank. This is a story of a young girl named Annie Frank. This story is based on her diary. Annie Frank is a Jewish girl who has to go into hiding during World War II to avoid the Nazis. She shared her experiences in the story when she is depressed. She doesn't have any close friend. She describes her all important experience in her childhood in her diary. After her death, Annie becomes world famous because of the diary she wrote while in hiding. So Annie Frank writes a diary because she didn't have any true friend with whom she could share her personal feelings. Let us move to the characters. The main characters of this chapter are, first of all, Annie Frank herself, the 13 years old Jewish girl who was introspective, means self-examining, and creative, and has a vivid imagination power. Margaret Frank, Annie's sister. Margaret Frank is Annie's sister. She is 3 years older than Annie. She is quiet and reserved. Otto Frank. Annie's father was Otto Frank and he was a Jewish businessman. He was very calm and loving. Now Mrs. Frank, who was Annie's mother, she loves Annie Frank very much. Now, Mr. Keesing, her teacher who punishes Annie as he gets annoyed by her talkative nature. Now, lesson at a glance. Annie Frank lived in Holland after Hitler invaded. His father and mother left her and her sister to her grandma. She was gifted a diary on her 13th birthday. She named it Kitty and made it her best friend in her solitude. Writing in a diary was a strange experience for her, as she thought that nobody would take interest in the musings of a 13 years old schoolgirl. It is strange because she has never written before anything in a diary before. So further she thinks that eventually neither anybody nor she herself will be interested in what she wrote. Still, she feels like writing to get things off her chest because she believes that paper has more patience than people. So she wrote every problem and happenings in her diary. She was very close to her grandma. After her death even, she felt very much alone and she missed her a lot. She believes that paper has more patience than people. That's why she decided to write a diary and she gave that diary a name, that was Kitty. She was lovable of every teacher except Mr. Keesing, who taught maths. She described her school days in her diary and even she described one particular day when the class was shaking with nervousness and anxiety because the teacher would soon announce who would be promoted to the next class. So the students were betting morning till night who would pass and who would not. But Annie was quite confident about herself and her girlfriends, though she was not so sure about how she performed in maths, because Mr. Keesing, who was her maths teacher, got annoyed with her talkative nature. She talked a lot in her classroom. So Mr. Keesing punished her by giving her extra homework many a time. First of all, she got one essay to write on a chatterbox. Then second time she got one more essay to write, and this time she got the topic an incorrigible chatterbox. Third time she got one more essay to write, this time she got this essay quack 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 sad mistress chatterbox. And her essay in verse means she wrote this third essay in poetry form, and this essay humiliated Mr. Keesing, and Mr. Keesing at last allowed Annie to speak or to talk in the classroom because she gave some logics. In her first essay, she said that talking was a student's trait, a child's trait, and she had inherited that trait from her mother. And she could not do anything with this inherited trait. So, in her essay, in third essay, she got help from her friend Senny, who was good in poetry. And Annie Frank wrote that essay in the form of verse. And at last, Mr. Keesing allowed her to talk and relieved her from any extra homework. Now, let's move to the main character of this chapter, who is Annie Frank. Annie Frank, the author of The Diary of a Young Girl, was born in Frankfurt, Germany on 12th of June 1929. She was an intelligent child. She was very wise for her age. She was different from the other children of her age. She was only 13, but could think very clearly and deeply. She knew the difference between friendship and true friendship. Actually, she had many friends, but she didn't have a true friend. That's why she thought to have a diary, to keep a diary. She had loving parents and a good home. Yes, she felt herself alone in the world. There was no one in whom she could confide. So she decided to keep a diary as a friend, and she gave it the name of Kitty. The very first entry in her diary reveals many things about her. She had a very sharp memory. She could write about her experiences in a clear and interesting manner. She had a keen sense of humor. She could invent amusing argument for any subject, as she gave one logic for her talkativeness. She said that she had got this trait from her mother, as her mother was also very talkative. So she said that she could not do anything on this. She was mature in her thoughts and presented herself as a promising writer. She was very talkative in nature. So her teacher, Mr. Keesing, gave her one topic after another as a punishment. As we have already discussed, that Mr. Keesing, her maths teacher, was always annoyed with her for talking too much. So he usually gave her extra homework and asked her to write an essay on the chatterbox, and then again on an incorrigible chatterbox. She wrote these essays with convincing arguments, telling that her mother also talks so much and that talking is a natural trait of students. And in third essay, She wrote that a swan father bit his three ducklings to death because they quacked too much. So luckily Mr. Keesing took the joke the right way and even read the poem in the whole class. After that, Mr. Keesing never punished any again. Rather, he cracked jokes with them thereafter. If she had lived longer, she would have been of the greatest writers of the world. So this is all about Anne Frank, who was born on June 12, 1929 in Frankfurt, Germany. Now, let us move to your homework. In your homework, you are supposed to read this chapter from the diary of Anne Frank carefully and revise all the questions and answers, summary and chapter highlight which we discussed in this lecture as well as in our previous lecture of this chapter 4, and solve the assignment based on chapter 3, two stories about flying, which has two parts, his first flight and the black aeroplane, and chapter 4, the same chapter of first flight book, uploaded in homework column on EdQuark site. So you are supposed to solve that assignment in your English FAIR notebook, and later on we will discuss this assignment. Thank you.